Hey guys, this is Dr. Jaws. Today I'm going to try something new and put videos on YouTube in order to explain more about the wonderful, wonderful world of sharks. Right now, let's dive into the magic of shark classification. So say you're at home watching your favorite rendition of Pride and Prejudice when all of a sudden a certain dark knight appears in your living room and says,
"Hey, I need your help with something."
Ah! You cry, both confused and concerned.
"I got attacked by a shark back in the 1960s. I just really want to know what species it was."
Okay, I guess I can help with that.
Here's a picture.
Upon looking at the photo, you decide that the best place to start is figuring out the order of the animal. So sharks come in 8 basic flavors. They are squatiniforms, pristophoriforms, squaliforms, hexanthiforms, carcharaniforms, limniforms, erectolobiforms, or heterodontiforms. Yes, they are all long and complicated names, but they're actually not that hard to understand once you break it down. First, determine whether or not your shark has an anal fin. If it does not have an anal fin, it can either be squatiniforms, pristophoriforms, or squaliforms. These three orders are pretty easy to distinguish from one another, as squatiniforms look like flattened pancakes, pristophoriforms have a really scary long nose, and squaliforms just are the other. But wait, your guy has an anal fin. Okay, that's great. Check out if it has one dorsal fin or 2 dorsal fins. If it has 2 dorsal fins, it can be one of 4 orders, but if it has 1, it can only be one thing, hexanthiforms. These guys look really freaky and are considered the most primitive looking sharks, but I think they're still really cool. Anywho, after you determine it has 2 dorsal fins and 1 anal fin, you have to figure out if it has spines or not. If it has spines and a ridiculously cute face, then that will be a heterodontiform. If it does not have spines, it can be one of 3 things, carcharhiniforms, limniforms, and or erectolobiforms. Now, erectolobiforms are pretty easy to separate from the other two, as they have their mouth placed well in front of their eyes. But carcharhiniforms and limniforms kind of look really similar, and the only way you can tell between the two is whether or not one of them has a nictitating membrane. What in the world is a nictitating membrane? It's basically a cool eyelid thing. When a carcharhiniform shark comes really close to prey, this eyelid thing comes up to protect it from any kind of damage. Limniforms lack this feature and so are always worried that their eyes will be poked out every time they go bite a seal. Now, as our shark has 1 anal fin, 2 dorsal fins, no fin spines, and a mouth that's placed either under or behind the eyes, it could be one of 2 things, a carcharhiniform or limniform. Fortunately, if you look really closely, we can see in this picture that yes, an eyelid thing is coming up as it bites its helpless, helpless victim. So, this is a carcharhiniform shark. Now, we can go into more detail, but I'll probably save that for another video. In the meantime, just settle on, hey, congratulations, you got a carcharhiniform.
Thanks. That wasn't really helpful.
Well, at least the general public has a better understanding of basic shark classification. So, go out there and try to class as many sharks as you can, because that's how you have fun. Thank you all for joining me, and this is kind of fun to do, so I'll probably post another video. I can't say sometime soon because my schedule is really busy, but definitely check out my Facebook page, just entitled Dr. Jaws, where you can see some crazy different ideas and approaches to certain species of shark. A la shark poetry. Have you ever seen shark poetry before? No, I guess you haven't, so you should probably check it out. Also, I do have a book, Carcharhinus Obscurus. It will be coming out... So keep your eye out for that. Adios, YouTube.